YouTube, Dubstep Slot 415, back again with another Sneakerhead Saturday. A little bit different of a video this week since I've only got 3 pickups so far. A few things before I get into today's video. I want to say thank you to all of my subscribers. Last week I hit 40,000, and as of 8:25 this morning, I was at 41,044. So I just want to say thank you to everyone. Also, I'm having an issue answering comments and private messages, so please be patient. Once YouTube gets that issue resolved, I will be answering everyone's comments and messages to my ability.
I've put together a schedule for the next few weeks for my videos. Next week, March 9th, will be my top 20 shoes in my collection. The following week, March 16th, will be my updated Snapback collection. I might be on a vacation the week of March 23rd, but I will finish off the month of March on the 30th with my Nike SB collection.
Getting into the last week of shoes. Up first, got the Nike Dunk VacTech Haystack. This was my favorite out of the 3 Haystack colorways to release. Was actually the only one I picked up. I passed on the Air Maxes and Air Forces. Got 2 pairs of the Ewing 33 Highs. Red suede colorway right here with your black and white accents. And then got your blue suede pair right here with your white and orange accents. Great pairs to wear on muggy days. Kind of use them as my winter boots out here in San Francisco. Next up, Reebok Kamikaze 2 Mid. Black and white. Classic shoe. Shout out to the homie Suicidal One. I know this shoe is his grail. The original release. Got the Jordan Bred 13s. Worn these a few times since they came out. Got a little dirt on the bottom. People ask me, what do I do for creasing? How do I keep my shoes clean? Jason Mark's shoe cleaner and creasing. I don't do anything for creasing. It's going to happen. Got your Concord 11s. The bottom starting to yellow. Finally, Jordan Bred 11s. That red bottom, you're not going to have an issue. A little sticker right there. So that's the last week of shoes. Let's get into today's pickups. Only got 3 pickups today, but they're 3 pairs I'm very happy with. Let's get into the pair on the right first. You see the Area 72 tag, Kobe 8 system. Kobe 8 System All-Star, Bright Crimson, Sport Turquoise, and Total Crimson. Let's focus that in. There you go. Gotta give a big thanks to my homie DrawingSkillZ for holding me down on these. So here we go with the Kobe 8 Area 72 Extraterrestrial. First off, you see that crazy sun flare upper. A lot of people are dogging them because they think it looks like a piece of pizza, but hey, it just means they couldn't get them. Got your extraterrestrial inner lining, your sport turquoise and bright crimson Kobe logo on the tongue. Your Nike swoosh has detail, very nice. Your outside swoosh has it as well. Got your very vibrant, bright crimson outsole. Looks to be solid, but with a little bit of translucentness, I guess. Got your composite glass, fiberglass. Your insole. Got your Nike Plus insole. This does have the ability to have Nike Plus, but this is the $180 version, so it doesn't come with it. You see the Kobe snake logo on the back. You guys remember that Kobe shirt I picked up a couple weeks ago? That's what these go with. So very pleased with the Area 72 Kobes. Move on to a brown Nike sportswear box. A lot of the EXT shoes, which means extension. It's a collaboration between Nike as well as another branch. This one is Kobe. Nike Zoom Kobe 8 EXT, University Red, and Court Purple. So these are the red suede Kobes. Very, very clean colorway right here. This is a collaboration between Kobe and the Nike Lifestyle brand. This is more of a casual wear shoe rather than a basketball. It's your very nice Court Purple outsole. Court Purple Kobe logo surrounded in University Red. Got a gold Kobe logo with a gold Nike swoosh on both sides. Actually, your inside swoosh is red suede. On the back, you do have your Kobe signature and Kobe logo. Now, some of the shoes have the full Kobe symbol and some don't. I believe that's what separates a US release from a China release. If I'm incorrect, please someone comment down below. But very pleased with these two Kobes. Final pickup of the day. I know a lot of people have been waiting to see this. I got easily 100 questions last week asking me if I cop these, even though I addressed it in the beginning of my video. See the brown Nike sportswear box. LeBron 10 EXT Cork QS, classic brown, University Red. This does have the original $305 retail, but they were dropped to $250 before the release. So here we go with the LeBron 10 Corks. First off, I gotta say props to Nike. They really went far past my expectations. I wasn't expecting these. I had some hesitations seeing pictures and early videos, but getting them in hand, they're definitely a very nice quality shoe. You see the LeBron lion right there on the back. Starting off the midsole, you got your all white midsole, your little plastic portion right there with the little designs. Wrapping around the entire shoe is a little bit of what looks like to be hemp material. Got your LJ10 logo in the front. Solid, like off-white outsole. Got your visible red LJ crown outlined in black. You see the inside of the air unit is red. So, I was really pleased with this Cork upper. You guys can see the extra laces have gold tips, or aglets, as people like to say. You can see these laces that are in right now don't have any tips, but they are like a solid rope leather. You can see your University Red flywire coming up. Your classic brown leather tongue. Moving up to an all leather tag with your LJ crown logo. The crown is in like a lighter brown, almost a gold. Your inner lining is very nice black leather stitched with a red design. You can see your inner lining, or not your inner lining, but your insole is all red. And it says LeBron James. The other one says World Champions. So very pleased with the LeBron 10 Corks. I don't think these are worth what people are charging. So if you can't get them for a reasonable price, it's not worth draining your bank account. I don't think they would handle too much heavy wear. And I know a lot of people are going to do that and then get upset when the shoe starts to fall apart.